never wanted any of this. I never wanted to be in the games. I just wanted to save my sister and keep Peeta alive.
Miss Everdeen, it's the things we love most that destroy us.
Everyone who's watching to lay down their weapons now.
You're alive.
Peeta is the Capitol's weapon, the same way you're ours.
You will rescue Peeta at the earliest opportunity, or you will find another Mockingjay.
Well, howdy, folks. K-Dog back with a movie of the week. And this time, we're here to review the latest installment of the Hunger Games series. That being the Hunger Games, Mockingjay Part 1. Sorry, I messed up the title there. But, just got out of seeing it tonight. Now, just a word of caution, this will be kind of a spoiler review. In case that if you haven't read the book or if you haven't seen the movie, turn this off right now. Because it's not worth, it's not worth me talking about unless I spoil some. If you read the book, you know the story, basically, I'm going to get into some things that explain what's in the trailer, what's going on. Well, like I said, this is the third installment of the Hunger Games series. Of course, I'm going to hold up my Blu-rays here. It all started with part one. We are introduced to Katniss Everdeen and her family of District 12, along with Peeta Mellark, and how these two meet, or they actually know each other, and they compete in the 74th annual Hunger Games, and how it kind of brings them together. Well, we move on from there, where they become the winners of the 74th Hunger Games. And also, I should make another disclaimer. If you have not seen Catching Fire yet, turn this off, because each film carries on from the next. And if you don't see part whatever, you're going to be left in the dust. So we move on from the first Hunger Games, move on to Catching Fire, where there is, by President Snow, issuing what's called a Quarter Quell, in which the which past contenders, they are entered in again, and it's just them competing in the Hunger Games. Now, that brings us to Mockingjay Part 1. As we left off in Catching Fire, we know that Katniss was picked up by a ship and was taken to what's called District 13, which is believed to be deserted. And we find out the Philip Seymour Hoffman character, I can't remember his name, even though I know what it is. I think it's Plutarch. I think is his name, but I'll put it in, over here somewhere. But we find out he's actually kind of a good guy. He's not, not only is he the games runner, but he's also a good guy. And what happened to PETA? All of a sudden, when Katniss shot the top, she exposed everything. It, you know, a lot of people will say, well, what happened to these other characters? There were several characters that went missing. Finnick O'Dare's partner, she's left. I mean, she was disappeared. Well, we find out where they've been. Again, spoiler. President Snow has been holding them captive in the Capitol. And he's been using PETA as propaganda. Now, again, if you've read the book or have already seen the movie, you know what I'm talking about. If you haven't seen it, turn this off right now. This is your last warning. We find out that PETA has been drugged. He has been drugged with a serum that is a blend of the Tracker Jacker from the first film. And it is controlling him and telling him what to say. President Snow has been using him for propaganda and using Katniss, saying that Katniss betrayed him, and has betrayed him, that the whole thing is a farce, and what happened wasn't supposed to happen, that everybody's supposed to obey the Capitol and stop this rebellion. If you are part of the rebellion, lay down your weapons now and just join in with the Capitol and you all will be merry. Well, that's not true. He's been injected with a serum that controls his thoughts and his mind. And in the meantime, Katniss has been found out to be what is called the Mockingjay. Basically, she is the symbol of hope. She is the leader of the rebellion. And just like President Snow, there's a new president of District 13 that still exists. And they start using propaganda to fight President Snow. So, there's like a whole film crew following her. And Philip Seymour Hoffman, he says, look, I know this girl. When she's passionate enough, she will do anything. And they start scripting what she should say, like a commercial, and she doesn't get it. So they put her in a real district. We take her back to District 12 where she's from. It has been decimated. Her district has been completely destroyed. What was once of 10,000 people, only 900 and something survive. And then when we find out what's going on with President Snow keeping the surviving tributes, the plan is to get them out of the tribute hall where they are being detained. So they are all rescued. They're all brought back, including PETA. But with this serum, they don't know its full potential. They know that he's been brainwashed. That's all they know. But when they find out what he's really been brainwashed with is when he first sees Katniss. When he first sees Katniss, he attempts to kill her. And they have to pry PETA off Katniss. He almost breaks her neck. And the end of the film, is basically say that there will be a rise of the rebellion, and there's an ending shot of PETA. He's on the bed. He's fighting the bed because he's strictly constrained. Because his anger and his fear are calculating against each other, and he's going mad. So there's the spoiler synopsis of what happens in part one. What did I think of the film? Well, I think this film is a good tie-in. I mean, it is a good tie-in between, you know, Catching Fire and to what is to be the climax of the whole entire piece. However, I am a little disappointed in some things. Again, I felt like it just seems like how, and it's not anything to do with the movie. That's the thing. I was disappointed on how Lionsgate is really treating it. But I don't think it may not be entirely their fault. Because the last two films were presented in the IMAX format. And of course, the second movie was shot using IMAX cameras. While this movie is just getting a 35mm release in the digital screens. That's it. There's no... Now, there may be a premium theater like AMC ETX or Regal's RPX theater release. There may be one of those. But other than that, there's no IMAX release, which I thought was quite surprising. That may be partial to Interstellar, because Interstellar was basically going to be the big movie of the winter. And, you know, it's taken up all the 70mm prints, the IMAX 1570 prints, and the digital IMAX and 35mm. You know, there's a whole list of formats in which that movie is based on. Or released on, excuse me. I said based on. But The Hunger Games, The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 1. It's a good tie-in because, like I said, with Catching Fire, I knew things were going to get dark. I said that Catching Fire was pretty dark. But Mockingjay definitely is taking a turn into more darker because it's one of those, to quote The Dark Knight, the dark gets lighter just before the dark gets lighter just before the dawn. Or how are that? I can't even quote it right, so I'm mixed up tonight. I mean, the movie is just—it's really sitting on my head now. But it's taking a turn for the darker. And again, I said for Catching Fire that it took the Star Wars approach, in which the first act you set up your characters, you set up the situation, you introduce the characters. You introduce the world that they are in. The second movie, or the second act, you take it and you put the characters into the worst possible situation that they could ever get themselves into. And Mockingjay Part 1 and Catching Fire, I believe, are kind of in that period where things are getting darker. But, keep in mind, I have not read the book. I read a synopsis of what the book is about and what's going to happen. But basically, in the fourth film, things are going to get even darker yet because there's going to be people killed, very close people that you care about. I'm not going to say who that is because, the movie isn't out yet, so I'm not even going to say who the character is. But, if you've read the book, you know who dies. I thought, in terms of the performance, I thought, this definitely was a little bit more emotional. The love story is now more of a... I found that a little confusing, is because I've always felt that, okay, Katniss, is she really attracted to Peeta or is she attracted to Gale? And a little of both, because this movie, it's more of Gale being by her side, but she still has these heartfelt emotions and love for Peeta that she wants to get him out. She wants him to be taken care of, and you know, she wants him by her side, and instead she has Gale, and Gale's doing that. It's just that whole love. I guess I don't understand it, but you know, with reading the synopsis, I should really get the books and really read the books and see, because a film's not going to always be faithful to the book. There's no way. The love between Katniss and Peeta is definitely there now. But it's a little strange to me. I guess I don't understand it. I was actually watching this in the theater tonight, and there was a scene where, you know, when Katniss actually is, when Peeta actually meets Katniss for the first time in the movie, and he goes ballistic. Then it showed how one of the guys pried Peeta off Katniss, basically knocks him unconscious. There was a girl around me, and I don't know how old this girl was, probably early 20s, late teens. She goes, "Aw." She's like, "Aw, why?" She had to blurt out, "Aw, they had to hit him." It's like, really? He's gonna be, I almost wanted to say, he's gonna be alright. Chill out. It's just a chill out moment. Build your tensions and boom. But, it's an enjoyable movie. I do go and see it into the theater. It's a very good movie. Another thing is, I'm glad Francis Lawrence is staying on to complete the whole series. I thought with Catching Fire, he upped the ante with the whole Hunger Games saga. Gary Ross did he's only directed the first movie, but I think it was because of him the ball got rolling that eventually the movie was going to be made. The whole book series was going to be made. And it's just, it's just a wonderful story. You know, it's a grim story. There's actually hope. There is some hope, in the whole thing, that, the whole story is that there's hope and that, there are evil people and it doesn't have to be that way. But, we'll just wait and see what Mockingjay Part 2 has in store for us. As far as I know, they're ending it with part two, but, there's a lot of stuff that's going to be happening in part two. I can guarantee you that, just the whole end of the story. So who knows? We'll wait and see what happens. So for me to you, see you later.